What's going on, guys? It's freezing in Toronto right now, and making cyanotype prints in the snow? Yeah, no thanks. So today I'm gonna show you everything you can do to recreate that stunning cyanotype look right in Photoshop without freezing your fingers off. Let's get into it.
All right, first up, you're gonna want a photo with high contrast and loads of texture. Cyanotypes love detailed subjects like flowers, leaves, architecture, or portraits with really dramatic lighting. I'm gonna be using this shot of the Burlington Skyway because it's perfect for that nostalgic cyanotype vibe. I've actually printed this one as a real cyanotype before, so we can use that for comparison. Next, you're gonna wanna open your photo in Photoshop and convert it to black and white. Go to Image, Adjustments, Black and White, easy peasy. Here I am just adding a little contrast to the photo with the level sliders. Basically, just by compressing the two sliders together, I'm giving the photo richer blacks and whiter whites. Go and duplicate your layer by pressing Command J or right click and hit Duplicate Layer. Now let's go ahead and add a paper-like texture to mimic that traditional cyanotype print look. Head to the filter menu and add the watercolor paper filter. Set the fiber length to 3, brightness to 65, and the contrast to about 70. In my experience, cyanotypes are never really crystal clear. For extra texture and noise, add a texturizer layer. So I set the scaling to 93 and the relief to 2. Once you're done with that, adjust the opacity of the texture layer to about 60 or 70%, whatever feels most natural. Now it's time for the fun part, turning it blue. To do this, go to Image, Adjustments, Hue Saturation, click Colorize. And set the hue to about 220. Pump up the saturation. I usually set mine to 34 so it's vibrant, but not too fake. I leave the brightness at 0, but adjust your own taste and based on each photo. You can also download overlays to put on your photo, which will further sell the effect. Little imperfections go a long way in making your Photoshop cyanotypes look authentic. To really sell that handmade look, add subtle vignetting or use the brush tool to rough up the edges. Choose a soft, irregular brush and lower the opacity for a natural effect. Since you've stuck around this long, here's a little bonus tip to make your life way easier next time. We're gonna save all these steps as a Photoshop action, so you can apply the cyanotype look in just one click. Head over to the Actions panel or go to Window, Actions if it's not visible. Click the Create New Action button. We're gonna name it Cyanotype and hit Record. Now, go through all the steps that we just did: black and white conversion, texture adjustments, toning to cyan, and adding those finishing touches. Once you're done, hit the stop button and your cyanotype action is created. Now, every time you want that cyanotype look, all you have to do is hit play on your action and Photoshop will do the rest. And there you have it, a cozy, winter-friendly cyanotype look made entirely in Photoshop. I hope you give this a try. Tag me if you do or drop a comment below. I'd love to see what you create. My Instagram handle is right here, so tag me in your photos. Stay warm, stay creative, and I'll catch you next time.